Namaskar. My name is Dr. Meghadeepa Chakravarti and I am working as assistant professor in the Department of Management Studies at Banasthali Vidyapith. Today I will talk about design thinking and effective problem solving approach in the contemporary era. We have discussed about the concept how the design thinking has evolved. Now let me take you through the different approaches of the design thinking. There are two broad categories of approaches in the design thinking, circular and sequential. There are many examples, but here I will discuss only two approaches. One, circular approach. Initial design thinking approaches were circular in nature. Let us see which is the circular approach of design thinking. Brown's design thinking approach. Tim Brown, along with David Kelly, the founder of the ADO, Innovation and Consultancy, conceptualized design thinking in circular approach. Brown's method of design thinking involves three steps, which Brown termed three spaces of innovation. First one, inspiration, second, ideation, and third, implementation. Now, what inspiration refers to? Inspiration refers to the problem or opportunity that motivates the search for solution. Ideation means the process of generating, developing, and testing ideas. Implementation means the path that leads from the project room to the market. The advantage of this nonlinear approach lies in the journey of the discovery, which makes the design thinker to be iterative and explorative. Innovation in any sector can go through refinement by iterating through these phases. Now, second, sequential approach, the Stanford School approach. The Stanford introduced this approach as a didactic process in which the main task of the model is to balance flexibility as well as sequentiality. The model is structured in a linear manner. However, forward and backward linkages can be made in the process. The approach categorizes the phases into the problem and solution space. What do you mean by problem space? The problem space comprises the phases, which includes understand, observe, and point of view. The solution space comprises the ideate, prototype, and test phase. In the phase of understand and observe, the exploration and analysis of the problem is vital in order to address the problem with solution, which generally attract less attention. Cross and Dorst define the co-evolution of problem and solution, which means the exploration of both the problem and solution space in parallel, in alignment with the concept of co-evolution. The Stanford Design School method follows iterating between phases. In this phase, great value is set towards problem solution. In the phase of point of view, the problem is specified elaborately and focus is on single user that questions the user's need and creates insight that will intensify the solution space. In this space of point of view, gathered data are organized and insights are defined. In the phase of ideate and prototype, solution phase begins with ideation. Ideating is a divergence and creative process through which solutions ascertained and corresponding prototypes are produced. During prototyping, an idea is made physically tangible, which promotes idea. Brainstorming and modeling characterizes this phase. Prototype serves as base for the last phase to test the prototype and test it in real application. Required modifications are made in the early stages if there is any demand or correction. Out of many approaches, the most common approach, which is followed in 5-stage, comprises of empathize, define, ideate, prototype, and test. Now, let me take you through the process of design thinking for solving any problem. I am referring to the framework developed by Civil Royal Service Commission, which anybody can use while applying design thinking in any of the problem solving process. Every step of design thinking is guided by questions as follows: who, what, and how. How to apply design thinking in problem solving situations. The process begins with the understanding of design challenges means the process begins with the acceptance of design challenge or a specific problem or a situation. With the help of scope framework, problem could be framed. What scope means? S stands for situation or problem. What is the situation or problem that you are trying to address? C stands for constraints. What are the constraints when trying to address the situation or problem? O stands for objectives and outcomes. What are the objectives and intended outcomes of this design challenge? P stands for people. Who are the people that you are trying to help? Whose problem are you trying to address? E stands for estimates. What are the estimated resources required for this design challenge? And S stands for scopes, which refers to ample scope to explore multiple alternatives to address the problem. Once the scoping of the design challenge is done, exploration phase begins to identify design opportunities from multiple perspectives. In the phase of exploration, you can use steep trend analysis, and that can be done to gain insight on the implication and context of the design challenge. What is steep analysis? You must be thinking. So, steep analysis is an effective tool to explore and determine the impact of macro environmental trends in the context of the project topic, which you are referring to design challenge. As you should not limit your thinking just to the people you are designing for. Different stakeholders like government, international partners, etc. may need to be considered in the process. Next is activity system. Activity system supports to map the organization's activity system for your new idea delivery. It is a visual representation of how the organization creates values, satisfies its users, and build competitive advantages. Stakeholder mapping. Stakeholder mapping is a process to identify the key people, group, and organization that have direct influence on the design challenge and understand the key stakeholders so as to better engage them, as stakeholders play a vital role in influencing the development and outcome of the design challenge. Last is frame opportunity. Design challenge into design opportunity. Opportunity framing prepares you to better define the design challenge, ensuring all relevant nodes have been considered before reframing the design challenge, and transform the design challenge into design opportunity with many possibilities. It is not only about thinking out of the box, but it is about the expansion of the box. Now, so what we really mean when we say empathize with the people in the process of design thinking? Empathize means, empathize is the mechanism to learn about the audience for whom you are designing by observation and interview. Empathy is used to uncover the deep user insights and needs by the gaining broader perspective of the citizen's life. It is guided by the questions, who is my user? What matters to this person? How can you make this process effective? This can be done with the support of framework like field observation. Structured approach to observing people in their natural environment to uncover user insights and fresh perspective of people and their behavior. So, observation is a great tool. While conducting field observation, one has to be attentive, curious, perceiving with all your senses and open-minded to learning. Now, what probably would be the best framework that you can make your observation effective? You can use POEMS framework, POEMS, POEMS framework. POEMS framework can be used, and that POEMS stands for people. Who are involved? Example, commuters, street vendors, office workers, children, motorists, delivery men, etc. What role do they play? What are the people engaging with each other? How are they related? What is the relationship? What is the social context? Now, O stands for objects. What artifacts are important? Example, bus stops, signage, traffic lights, anything that attracts you. What roles do they play? How are people engaging with the objects and with their surroundings? What is interaction? How does object influence people's behavior? Environment. E stands for environment. Where is the action taking place? Is it in public bus, roadside, government office, garden, etc.? It could be anywhere. So, what is happening? What are the people doing? How do the people behave in these spaces, in this environment? So, how does the environment influence people's behavior? What is the mood, ambience? So, all these things can be considered in environment. Now, it comes M, messages and media. What are the messages and communication media used? So, example, signage, online material, posters, apps, etc. So, what roles do they play? And S stands for what are the services and support system provided? Example, registration, library service, hands-on guide, online booking, etc. So, while doing poem thing, while empathizing, the using of poem framework can help you to get into a effective observation. Now, coming to the next step, define. So, how you define the problem? So, define means to create a point of view that is based on user's need and insights. What are their needs? In what best possible way one can engage in need findings? When conducting need finding, you are looking for patterns and relationship. And in this case, you can actually use the SPICE framework and SAM framework. So, think, feel, do framework to uncover insights, aspiration, motivation, challenges, pain points and deep needs. What SAM framework stands for? Social context. Who they do the action or activity with? What is their relationship, social interaction? Why they behave the way they do? So, these are the questions you can actually explore. Action. Behavior. What is the behavior? What action or activities they are involved? Why they are involved? Motivation. What do they think? How do they feel? What are the reasons for actions and or behaving that way? Beliefs, values, all these things can be explored in the process of SAM. SPICE. Now, you can use the SPICE framework. SPICE, S stands for social. So, what does this person need? Form relationship with the people around them. Example, trust, qualified counsel, resourceful services, staff, etc. P stands for physical. What does this person need on a functional and practical level? Example, responsive service, conducive environment, access to amenities, etc. I stand for identity. What does this person need to define themselves? Example, to be a contributor, raise civic consciousness, etc. C stands for communication. What information does this person need? Example, non-bureaucratic language, access to reliable information, responsive feedback, channels, etc. E stands for emotional. What does this person need emotionally and psychologically? Example, sense of national pride, sense of fairness and justice, etc. And in the end, ideation. This is the ideation phase where huge quantity of idea is generated by brainstorming using the ideation tools. The ideas are then prototyped to provide user with ideal user experience journey. Now, how can you use the framework to generate idea? So, there is a framework called Scamper. Your idea can be drawn from any of those sources where Scamper can be helpful. So, S stands for substitute. What might you substitute? Who else? What else? Where else? What parts? What material you can substitute? So, C stands for combine. What can you combine? What might I combine this object with? Can I combine ideas? Can I combine objects and functions? What this also include or do? A stands for adapt. What might I change? What else is this like? What does this remind me of? What might I copy? So these are the things which will always help you to generate your ideas. So following these questions, you can always look forward for new thing to come up. So M stands for modify, magnify, minify. How might I change it? Bigger, smaller, what might I increase or decrease? How can I enhance or diminish attributes such as color, texture, sound, taste, smell, speed? P stands for put to other. Use. Are there other uses of this object? What happens if I change the context or function or purpose? E stands for eliminate. What can I do without? What can I take away or remove? R stands for reverse. Rearrange. What if I turned it upside down, backwards, inside out? What if I rearrange any parts, function or objectives? Idea can also be developed using ideation analogous. Analogous inspiration helps to draw innovative ideas from various organizations and industries. It provides different perspective and prompt new and creative ideas. Idea generation by deconstructing or reconstructing also happens. Now, deconstruct and reconstruct is the process of taking a product or service and initially break it down into its essential parts, core components, key elements, significant strength, etc., and then reconstruct idea and imagine new possibilities by combining features, characteristics. Now, the next is prototyping. What is prototyping? Prototyping is an approach that makes ideas and concepts more tangible and visual as compared to written ideas. We usually write an idea, but how it is going to come into a final shape? Prototype helps us in doing that. So, it is a stage to build a representation of one or more of the ideas to show to others. It helps us to empathize with the user in terms of the viability of the solution and further minimizes the risk of failure at large scale. Basically, to think, how can I show my idea? Remember, a prototype is just a rough draft. So, it's not the final one. So, after you develop the prototype, you actually go to your customer, your client, your consumer to test your idea. So, testing is another phase where you, after your solution concepts and prototypes are ready, share your ideas in the form of prototyped with the original users for feedback. Give users the walkthrough experience and using ideal user experience journey. Feedback and comments from the users are taken with open mind and is being reviewed to come to a common understanding about which idea works and which does not work for the user and why. Finally, refinement of the solution idea is done. So, these are the five important steps of design thinking. So, thus I come to the concluding part where I thank you for giving your time in listening to this session. Thank you.